Government's move to rationalize its entities in a bid to cut public expenditure has suffered another setback as members of parliament turned down government requests to pass the bills, citing massive irregularities.
The bills that were here were presented with certificates of financial implication, albeit they were not sufficient and they are being amended. I am of the considered opinion that that amendment would suffice.
For the bill to be a bill before the House of Amendment, it must be accompanied by a certificate of financial regulations. Does he mean that now we don't have the bills? We don't have them because there is no certificate. That's what
we agreed, the bills be sent to the committees. It is from the committees that we've realized there was a mistake on the certificates, which must be corrected.
Bills on rationalization of several other agencies and departments were, however, withdrawn on the basis of absence of certificates of financial implication.
Serious matter, grave. Kindly allow the Attorney General to tell this parliament that a bill that was brought in that fashion will not have to first be withdrawn for it to be introduced. I want Madam Speaker, the Attorney General, to tell us, because this is a precedent that we are setting as parliament, that they can throw documents and then begin correcting them haphazardly like they brought them.
Properly directing its mind to the law and to the facts would come and report to us and throw these bills and ask the Attorney General to come with, I don't know, a garbage truck or something to take them back. That's what I would expect to come here.
We have an act of parliament called the Rationalization of Government Agencies. Do we have it? So what are we amending? So I will invite members of parliament to find this omnibus way of amending by way of repeal or amendment objectionable.
The Deputy Chairperson, Committee on Legal and Parliamentary Affairs, Yusuf Mutembuli, moved parliament when he pointed out that a certificate of financial implication cannot be amended when the bill has already been introduced.
Be alive to the fact that section 76(1) is the one that guides us. When do you need this certificate? The certificate is needed at the time when the bill is being introduced in the parliament. Madam Speaker, there is no way a certificate can be amended when the bill has already been introduced.
Attorney General actually was not chased. Our agreement with him was that these things can be corrected. The Attorney General, who is now running everywhere like a headless chicken,
wanted to correct the issue of the certificates. Which certificates is ready to lay? Then it is upon you in the committee to scrutinize what is required. If Attorney General is able to defend his position, let it be so.
The sectors whose bills have been withdrawn were lumped up and were expected to be passed in an omnibus manner, including works and transport, trade, social development, education, internal affairs, finance, water and environment, agriculture and tourism. The Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, guided that the bills will be retabled by the respective ministers.
To move that the bill entitled the Rationalization of Government Agencies, Works and Transport Sector be withdrawn.
And Sector Amendment Bill 2024 be withdrawn. Thank you.
Amendment Bill 2024 be withdrawn.
Withdrawn, and we'll wait for the respective ministers to come and retable them when they are ready.
However, Parliament passed the National Records and Archives Amendment Bill 2024 to disclose the National Records and Archives Agency and transfer its functions to the Ministry of Public Service.
That the National Records and Archives Amendment Bill 2024 be read the second time. I beg to move.
The Minister of Public Service, Wilson Mururi Mukasa, assured the affected staff that they will be incorporated into the ministry. Reports compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.